my name is Anthony Hall, and in this tutorial, we're just going to do a quick follow-on from my last tutorial, where we shown the shark going through the flock, school of fish, and skimming it at the end there. What I want to just quickly show you is how you can clone the whole hierarchy of the actual shark, or the school of fish, in fact, and manipulate the clone hierarchy, so you can have two fish or two sharks or three sharks or three schools of fish or whatever if you want, and then just recalculate it. So basically, just make sure, go to your scene editor on here on your side, go to the actual shark, and there's all the hierarchy for it. Right mouse click, go to add, and go down to where it says clone hierarchy, and then it will clone everything again. So we'll go on the second one, look. So we've got the second hierarchy. Now it's in exactly the same place, obviously. So what we'll do is we'll go to modify, and we'll go to move path. So what we're going to do is we're going to move the whole path. So what you'll see now is two sharks swimming at the side of each other, like so. Okay. I mean, we could move this one back a little bit. Let's move it a bit back to the side. So now it's behind, and it still goes through like so. So once you've done that, if you want to manipulate the actual path, you can go to each keyframe on your timeline and then simply move the actual, go on to the main move tool and move the actual keyframe if you want, or you can go to the path tool, and this will put this little crosshair here on each keyframe, which you can then manipulate the keyframe and move it around without adding any keyframes or doing anything to your timeline apart from changing where the actual shark is going to go. Now when you do this, unfortunately, it doesn't give you the option to rotate, so you will have to rotate it yourself on that keyframe. But that's the way you could manipulate it as well. So if you wanted, so I mean, obviously it's turning as normal here, so on and so forth, but you can come into any of you can come into any of the actual crosshairs that we've just shown you and manipulate them if you want on that shark. If we just reselect it, actually, I just deselected it, and then obviously it shows you each one of the actual could just manipulate it slightly. Let's say we wanted that, just slightly move it like so. Let's just go back to we'll go back to the rotate tool, and then if we bring it back, you can see now it's not quite on the actual path, so we just need to address how the shark or where the shark is facing at certain points, so you kind of back on, it looks like it's back on track and not floating sideways. I mean, if you're going to do, I mean, personally, I would probably do some kind of path for it to follow instead, and have a better bone kind of rig in it to make it more smoother and better. However, I'm just doing this quickly, like I said, to show you how you can use the flocking system. Just remember, once you've done it and you've done the animation, you need to recalculate it. So you simply just go to the effects tool and then click recalculate, and then when you press play, they'll the school official try and stay away from both sharks and reform back into their school. And you can do exactly the same thing with the actual school. So if we go back up here and we go to the actual, it's up to you. I mean, you can just clone the school of fish like we did before, and then move it to a different position if you wanted, or you could just you can actually clone it more than once. You can do as many as you want. You can clone it all. You can clone five times at once. But I wouldn't do that. I would do it one at a time. Otherwise, you're going to be quite confused doing it and stuff. So again, if you wanted to clone the maybe school of fish, let's go to the flock one. Right mouse click. Add. Clone. Okay, so we've got two lots now, but let's just go to modify, move path, and move the second one somewhere else. Now, once I've done this, I've cloned that actual school of fish, so it's that school of fish is going to, again, try to get to the actual path it was created, the goal path that I was created to follow, so both are going to swarm together, so you've got twice as many. You just got to remember to go to calculate, and then if you see what I mean, both, you've got both schools here following the path from different ways, but they are at the same time. Staying away from the actual distance range here. Look, you see it's on the edge of the range and stuff until it gets quite close to the goal, because they're both schools of fishes, look, have got the same command, is to try and get to that goal in whatever way they can, but it's stopped by, again, you've got these the range force fields and stuff, right? And you've got double one actually. But you can go in and change this, because I've cloned it in the flocking system, you will get that clone as well. So you can come in here, and before, let's make sure variants on. I mean, we could. In fact, let's go and have a look. So some of the, let's reduce the range here of both sharks and just recalculate, so it's not as wide, and then let's see now. Yeah, again, you can bring it in even closer if you want, and so on. Yeah, so that was just a quick update of how you can actually clone the actual hierarchy of the shark, or if you want to just clone the flock of fish. And when you do clone it, it clones everything, all the attributes to it, including, like I said, with the fish, the target. But and then what it'll do is it'll give you all the cloned in here, so you can go and then give it a separate goal if you want for the fish to try and follow, or you can manipulate the settings so they're not exactly the same on each, and so on. So again, I'm just going to stop there, just because I just wanted to do like a little follow-on from this about how you clone this. So please share, subscribe, check out Lightwave Salvation Facebook group. Like I mentioned in my last tutorial, I'm going to look at maybe doing a fleet of spaceships, avoiding structures in some way in my next tutorial. So look out for that. Thanks for watching.